One of the toughest challenges with making chicken on the grill is getting that skin nice and crispy just like it was fried. Now, if you're tired of grilling chicken with rubbery skin, stay tuned and I'm going to share with you my three secrets to grilling perfect crispy chicken on the grill. There's nothing worse than biting into a piece of grilled chicken and having the skin soggy and stretched like a rubber band. I don't care how good it tastes. If the skin is soggy, I'm not gonna eat it. Now today I'm gonna share with you my three top secrets to grilling crispy chicken. And stay tuned, the final secret, that's the most important one. You don't wanna miss that one. I recently posted a video to my channel where I grilled some amazing buffalo wings with all three of my tips, along with a recipe for some homemade buffalo sauce and some blue cheese dressing. I'll put a link here and below in the description. Secret tip number one. It's important to make sure that that skin is totally dry before that chicken goes on the grill. After pulling mine out of the refrigerator and rinsing it off, I like to pat it completely dry with a paper towel, making sure all the water is off that skin. I then place each piece on a drying rack and place it back in the refrigerator while I heat my grill up. This step will really ensure that that skin is completely dry. Okay, secret tip number two. It's important to have your grill up to 400 degrees before the chicken goes on. Now, normally when we smoke anything on the grill, we want it at 250 degrees, but not for chicken. I want my grill at 400 degrees, and when I put the chicken on, I put it on the indirect side. That means positioning it so it's away from the heat. On my Kamado Joe, I put a vortex in the middle of the grill and put the chicken around the outside. Now, if you don't have a vortex, I'll put a link below to the one that I use. For a gas grill, that means turning on one or two burners on the end, leaving the rest off, and that's where the chicken goes. On a charcoal grill like a Weber, you want to bank all the coals to one side and put the chicken on the other side. This higher temp will really help that skin crisp up. Okay, so here is a bonus tip. Chicken is fully cooked when it reaches an internal temperature of 165 degrees. But when I grill my chicken, I'd like to take it to 170 degrees. This extra 5 degrees really makes a difference and you won't be disappointed. It'll help crisp up that skin. If you're getting some good advice from this video, please consider hitting the like and subscribe button below. But before I move on to my third and final tip, I wanted to share something with you that really warmed my heart this week. I got a call from my daughter, and my grandkids live clear on the other side of the country. She let me know that my grandkids love watching my videos on YouTube. So I want to take a moment and say hi to both of them. Grayson, Alyssa, Grampy loves you, and I really miss you, and I can't wait to see you again. Okay, here is my third and final secret, and this one is the most crucial, so are you ready? The secret is to dust your chicken before it goes on your grill. And not just with any barbecue rub or seasoning, it needs to contain my secret ingredient, and that's baking powder. Baking powder really works to help pull the moisture out of that skin and allows it to crisp up nicely. My GNC wing dust is the key to getting crispy skin on your chicken. I'm gonna post a recipe in the description below. Now, I make it here in bulk in the GNC kitchen and I store it in a mason jar because we use this stuff so much. It's great on any chicken you wanna put on the grill. Here's what I put in mine. 4 tablespoons of that baking powder that I mentioned, 2 teaspoons of kosher salt, 4 teaspoons of onion powder, 4 teaspoons of garlic powder, and I like to throw in a couple teaspoons of my chipotle powder. I put it all in the mason jar and mix it up really well. These measurements work great for about 10 pieces of chicken or 24 wings. What I like to do is I like to take 10 of the wings and put them in a gallon size Ziploc bag. And then I'll add a tablespoon of our GNC wing dust that we made earlier, right into the top. Then I'll close it up, make sure I got plenty of air in there, and then I'm gonna shake it up really good. It's like the old shake and bake commercials. Gotta make sure every one of the wings gets nice and coated. There you go. Now they're ready for the grill. I really hope you found these three tips useful. And if you'd like to watch the complete video on grilling those crispy buffalo wings with the blue cheese dressing, check on the link right up here. Thank you again for joining me in the GNC Kitchen. And if you like this video, here's a few more you might enjoy. Now you can find me on Facebook and Instagram at Grillin' and Chillin' with Coleman. And also consider liking and subscribing here. And don't forget to click that bell. It'll let you know when I have some new videos out. Now I've got some chicken wings to go eat, so y'all go grill something.